Hi, AT from CNC at Home. Today I want to show just some basic features of the LightBurn software and how I can take this 108 millimeter square and create a grid. The grid will be 3 squares by 4 squares with no spacing in between them. In each of these squares, I'm going to put a number and some letters to represent a telephone keypad. You'll notice that the squares are larger than my cutting area, so this whole thing will end up getting rotated by the time I'm done. So we'll start out with a 72-point font. I'm going to use Toma, and I'll just put the numbers in each one of the squares. Each square gets a single number, 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. The next step is to align all of the numbers and the two symbols within each of the squares. So what I'll do first is I'll take this column of numbers and I will align them in the center, and then I'll do that for the next column and the next column, and then I'll do each one of the rows of numbers as well, get those centered in the grid. Once everything is centered, then I'm going to actually take the horizontal and bring everything up, because I need those numbers closer to the top, because I'm going to be putting letters underneath each one of those that represent the number 2 or the number 3. You'll see that in just a moment. So once we get everything centered up the way we need it, then we can start putting in the next round of letters. On this bottom row, only the 0 is raised up because it's the only one that is going to have any letters underneath it. The asterisk and the pound stay as they are. Now we're going to go add some more letters, and we're going to use a 24-point font, and the 1 doesn't get anything. The number 2 gets an A, B, and a C. Number 3 gets the D, E, and F, and so forth. And on the 0, we type in operator. Then we'll take all of these letters, we'll center them horizontally, get them centered vertically, and then bring them down to the appropriate level. All right, now we grab the whole thing and we rotate it 90 degrees clockwise. Once it's rotated, then we just push it down into the lower corner and we're really all set to burn. There are just a few other adjustments. I will need to take all of my letters and numbers and add them to their own layer so that I can control them separately from the squares that represent each of the tiles. Those squares will be set to not output, and the numbers and letters will be set to output. I'll just highlight these two squares and get them assigned back to the black layer so that they won't burn with the rest of the stuff. I do have the squares representing each of the tiles in their own layer. That way I can shut them off, they don't burn. Here's what it's going to look like. This is going to make a great little project. In the next video, we'll get the tiles all lined up and start the burn.
Oops.
Hi, I'm AT from CNC at Home. If you like our content, help support our channel by clicking on subscribe and liking our videos. Thank you for watching this video. Have fun with your CNC at Home projects.